Thank you, Tim. It was clear that those words came right from the heart. Wow, what a special lady. It's always hard to try to capture 80 plus years of life in a matter of minutes. Let's see what we can do. Bobby was born in Coleman, Texas, the first of two children born to Carl and Ethel Stewart. Grew up in Texas, then Arizona, then California. She met the love of her life, Jim, in line at a movie theater in Long Beach, California, when they were only 17 and 18 years old. A romance quickly ensued, and they were married on August the 29th of 1953. Do the arithmetic, that's 64 years together. Precious years, every one of them. Exclamation points of love and devotion. Bobby and Jim were the proud parents of Jim, Larry, Lori, and Kim. And as you all know, she was active in her kids' lives with Cub Scouts, Campfire Girls, Girl Scouts, Mini Marchers, and their various sports. She herself had numerous hobbies, which she enjoyed most getting to share with other people. Things like her craft projects of any kind, interior decorating, playing cars, we just heard the story of the Bentley box, cruising, road trips, making beautiful scrapbooks for the kids and the grandkids that will surely be treasures cherished for years. Bobby loved attending live theater and plays, lunches with the kids, even Disney on Ice with grandkids, I understand. Finally retired from working after 32 years with the Navy Exchange. And as you well know, she was a loving and devoted wife to her husband, Jim. She was grateful for his strength, devotion, and hard work for her and for their kids. Bless you, my brother. May God comfort you in these coming days. Her favorite times, as we've already heard and heard so compellingly, were when all of her kids and grandkids would gather for holidays, barbecues, and celebrations. She would never miss a birthday, a graduation, or a special activity for any of her kids or her grandchildren, and treasured every moment she spent with her family and was so proud of them all and loved her children and her grandchildren dearly. She was preceded in death by her father, Carl, by her mother, Ethel, and by a son, Jim. She is survived by James, her husband, by Freddie, her brother, Linda, her daughter-in-law, Lori, her daughter, Larry and Gloria, a son and daughter-in-law, Kim and Ben, a daughter and son-in-law, 11 precious grandchildren, Jimmy, Carly, Justin, Casey, Kyle, Dustin, Janelle, Jessica, Heather, Elena, and Eric, and 9 just as precious great-grandchildren, Ethan, Trevor, Dylan, Bella, Jackson, Evelyn, Alana, Aaron, Danny, and Elliot. And if we were to try to list all of the friends, we would be here till supper time. So we won't even try to do that. As a pastor, I will say that it was not my privilege to serve as a spiritual shepherd to Bobby during the years that she and her family attended here at Midway at privileged fell to Pastor Jim Bates. But as the family talked with me about her spiritual life and walk, they reassured me that when she was still a child, she proudly made